Let's add 19 and 3/18 to 18 and 2/3. So I like to separate out the whole number parts from the fraction parts. So 19 and 3/18 is the same thing as 19 plus 3/18. And to that, we are going to add 18 and 2/3, which is the same thing as 18 plus 2/3. Now we can separately add the whole number parts. So we could add the 19 to the 18. So we could do 19 plus 18. And then we can add the fraction parts. Plus 3, let me do this in green. Plus 3/18, plus 3/18, plus 2/3, plus 2/3. Now 19/18, pretty straightforward. That is what? Let's see, 19 plus 19 would be 38, so there's going to be one less than that. It's going to be 37. So that gives me 37. And then 3/18 plus 2/3, to add them, I need to have the same denominator. And the least common multiple of 18 and 3 is 18. So let's convert 2/3 to something over 18. So 2/3, if I want to write it as something over 18, well, I multiply the denominator by 6, so I'd also have to multiply the numerator by 6. So it's the same thing as 12/18. So I can rewrite 2/3 as 12/18. And now I can add these two things together. That's going to be, so I have 37 plus, it's going to be something over 18, plus something over 18. 3 plus 12 is 15. Plus 15/18. And so expressing this as a mixed number, I get 37 and 15/18. And that's the right number, but we can simplify it even more. We can simplify the 15/18. Both the numerator and the denominator are divisible by 3. So let's divide them both by 3. And we're not changing the value because we're doing the same thing to the numerator and the denominator. And so this gives us, we still have our 37. We still have our 37, but the numerator is now 5, and the denominator is now 6. So we get 37 and 5/6. 37 and 5/6. And we're done.